Hey everyone, my name is Marshall Mind, bringing you a brand new video. And today we'll be going over the featured fighters of the day, day number four. And I gotta say, when I look at the list of fighters that we have right here, some of these fighters they're not really that low rated. For example, I see Jose Aldo in there and I see John Dodson in there. So it's pretty interesting list we have here. I'm just very glad that a vast majority of them are in the lower weight classes, because when you get to the lower weight classes, the fights, the stat difference does not get way too drastic. So we've got Rick Story, we've got Jose Aldo, we've got John Dodson, we've got Ortiz, and we've got Panay in the straw weight division. So let's kick things off with Rick Story in the welterweight division. I used Rick Story in the beta. I didn't think he was that good. I felt like he was pretty slow. I felt like his punches were sluggish, and he didn't have that pop that you would expect a guy that powerful to have in the game. But he's not one of the worst fighters that I've ever used, so we should be able to do pretty decent with him in the welterweight division. In the meantime, I'm gonna skip ahead until I get a fight, and I'll be right back with you guys as soon as I get a fight. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we are. We've got a fight in the welterweight division. Let's see if we can find Rick Story so that we can get this thing going. Where is he? Rick Story. There he is. 88 overall, stand up 86, submissions 86, the clinch 88. Pretty, I'd say, overall decent. Crushing presence. Let's see when you are. Oh my god, it goes by so slow. In the dominant position. Back constrictor, wake up call, carved wood. Okay. So he's just a tough guy, basically. Let's go with the black trunks and let's get this thing going. Hopefully, we get a good fight. The welterweight division was the division that was featured in the beta, so a lot of people got to, gain a lot of experience. Hopefully, we'll possibly be facing, Tyron Woodley. So this should be a good fight. This should be a good fight. We've got two power punches in there. Our reach is about the same. It's not that different. Height. Not that different, so we should be able to touch each other pretty easily. But if this fight gets too ridiculous, I'm going to try to take it to the ground. We'll see what happens. This is a decent matchup. It's a pretty good matchup. Let's touch up. Who are we facing? Killer Instinct. I don't know who that is. This person is aggressive. We like it when they're aggressive like that. Coming forward with the leg kicks. So we're just going to hang back a little bit. Just see what he's doing. See what he's doing. And then just go from there. Good connection with the straight by Story. And he lands the okay. Right. Good solid straight right. So it's the leg kicks followed by the uppercuts. You can see the game plan. Punish his opponent's leg. Absolutely. So let's just see if we can. Now, do you really want to take the fight to the ground? So he's going for the leg kicks, which is okay. That's all right. The good thing here is his stamina is going down. That's okay. That's all right. Full guard. That's all right. Because the good thing about the ground game is, at the end of the day, I will end up on top. And that is bad news if you're not as good as I am on the ground. Like this dude right here. And this fight is over. Good fight, buddy. Good fight.
Rick the Horror Story with the victory.
He was way too aggressive. Way too aggressive. Just, it didn't look like he knew exactly what he wanted to do. He was just way too reckless. Way too reckless. So we got him out of there. I don't know who that guy is. We got him out of there pretty quickly with Rick the horror story. Let's move on. Let's move on to the next fighter. We've got Jose Aldo. Now, a lot of people will be probably jumping up when they see the name Jose Aldo, but I'm really not. I feel as if they've never really got Jose Aldo down right. I don't like the way his body looks. They finally got his stance correct. He's got that high Muay Thai stance going now, so he looks much better. Apart from that, I feel as if his movesets don't really do him justice. His leg kicks are not powerful enough. I don't feel as though he is as fast as he's supposed to be, and not as powerful as he's supposed to be as well. There's just something wrong about the way Jose Aldo still feels at this point in the game. But I don't have much experience with Jose Aldo. I've used him maybe once or twice, so we'll try to get some cage time with Jose Aldo if I can get a fight. But in the meantime, I'll skip ahead, and once I get an opponent, I will be right back with you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Jose Aldo. Let's get a fight with Aldo and see what's up with him. First of all, hold on. Let me look at his stats. This took me a while to get into. So he's got decent stamina, 93. Look at his... Okay, decent. He's got good leg kicks. Pretty good in the Muay Thai clinch, which means that a lot of players are going to be using the Muay Thai clinch with Jose Aldo. I'm still not a fan of Aldo. I'm really not. I mean, not in real life. I'm not saying in real life. In the game, he doesn't feel good to me. He doesn't feel fast enough. He feels kind of sluggish to me. But we'll see what happens. Let's go ahead and see what happens. Hopefully we're not facing an opponent.
Coming up next,
facing Khabib. That's okay.
Jose Aldo and Khabib.
I'm gonna get ready to grapple a little bit. I have a feeling this fight might get taken to the ground. I'm gonna try to stand up for a little bit just to get a feel of what his striking looks like, and then we'll go from there. Touch gloves. There you go. Who am I facing? I don't know who that is. That leg kick, jab straight, jab straight. Let's move around a little bit. Got me down. That's okay. You just better have a good ground game. That's all I ask. Get you back here.
He postures up and delivers.
Pull him down.
Shot to the body.
Let's get up.
Joe, both of them stand up here. Good job blocking the punch.
Got the leg kicks.
Vicious leg kick.
Softening his opponent up, trying to set something up here.
Caught me with that one. All right, well, let's play.
Really good movement on the ground.
Let's get him back down to the ground.
And he gets to his back. And he gets it.
You've had your fun on the top. It's time to have my fun. Good thing is Khabib has a pretty... Try to get him back down. Denied that one. Get him back down to the ground.
Half guard.
Just fake the trans. God damn it. Come on. Fake it.
Now he's in
fake. Gets him out. There we go.
Oh, there
Wow. I can feel Habib's ground game. Let's get to mount. Wow. I'm defending the transitions, but nothing's happening. Let's get the side control. There we go. Timed that one right. Oh no, I missed it. He got up. Get up. Caught him. Leg kick. The Aldo is too slow. He's just slow to me. He's way too slow to me. Way too slow. It's just he still doesn't feel as fast and as snappy as he's supposed to feel like. That's really why I don't use Jose Aldo. He's just, they haven't got him right yet. They've not got Aldo right yet. I mean, that high kick is just, he just comes up so slow. Look at that. I mean, get up. Oh my goodness. Back up. Left hand. Man, that right eye's really looking swollen. Jose Aldo is way too slow. He's way too slow. Caught him with a right. Yeah, again, nice straight right. Joe, there we see our total strikes landed so far. And they gave him like a Superman punch. He's slow. Dice, knee to the body. Standing and trading. Exactly what we had hoped for. Push kick. Jose Aldo is on point with his jab tonight. Let's try to catch this dude. Really good use of that jab. He's hurt. He connects again. You know what's coming. Drop him. Let's get him out of here. Unless you use your clinch with Aldo, unless you try to use the clinch with Jose Aldo, he does not feel good on the feet. At least not to me. Not to me. He just doesn't feel as fast as he's supposed to. That's my problem with him. But we got the win. Let's move on. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb. All right, let's move on to John Dodson, bantamweight. Very interesting. They want me to use him in the bantamweight division. All right, I'll be right back with you guys once I get a fight. All right, here we go. Here we go. We've got a fight in the bantamweight division. Let's look for Mr. Where is he? Where is he? John Dodson. 90 rated, 93 stand up. Let's look at his perks. Untouchable. Heavy hands, game changer. So you want to put your hands on your opponent when you're using John Dodson. So that's pretty good. All right, let's see who we're facing.
Between Ultimate Fighter winner John the Magician Dodson and Thomas Dominguez Almeida.
And we are facing Thomas Almeida. For this bantamweight battle. Or Tomas Almeida, however you say his first name. Dodson is 31. Should be a good fight. He will have a 6-inch. He's going to have a height and reach advantage on us. So if we can't make our way on the inside, we're going to have to take this fight to the ground, guys, because I really don't want to have to deal with having to reach disadvantage. So let's see. Death Wish MMA. Oh, Lord. I know who this is. I know who this is. This is... I believe this is... guy's name is Mike the Problem. It's going to be hard to win this fight. Get up. Keep him with a jab straight.
Almeida with a solid jab. Wow, what a great job mixing things up. Joe, you can hear Greg Jackson wants Dotson to keep his hands up.
You guys would do me like this, putting me in a fight with a very good player when I have a shorter fighter. God damn it. God damn it. Ah, I knew that was coming.
And he pulls away. Precise jab by Almeida.
Get out of here.
Back and forth. Dotson's blocked that strike. And he's down. Back up again. Flag needed. Dotson with the strong combination.
Move around. See what happens.
Solid straight punch. Another good strike. Clean left hand. We just got out of the way there.
Okay.
Dotson. Oh, big right hand. He hurt him. Looking to finish the fight.
Defended against that one well. Okay. Just move around a little bit. Move around.
Flying knee. Oh, that's a big left. Oh, and another jab.
Caught me with that. Getting caught with those leg kicks.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots.
Oh, Lord. Man, I wish the parries were not in the game. It would just be so much more better. I mean, like, when you look at what he's doing, it's parry head, parry body, parry head, parry body. It just makes the game so... I don't even know, like, how to even think about it. I wish the parries were not in the game. I really do. I wish we just had to depend on our head movement. Using sways... using footwork, and the parries were just gone. I really do. I wish that's the way it worked.
There's a nice leg kick. And here's a...
this is going to be a difficult fight to win. It's going to be a hard fight to win for a few reasons. Dotson is faster. That's the good thing. He's faster. He's got power. But... I'm having to contend with the leg kicks, and I'm having to deal with the fact that my opponent is a fucking parry god. I mean, it's just...
he blocks the punch. Almeida's got him in the plum clinch. Oh, and he eats a nice knee. Oh! That big knee might stop this fight. Oh! Nasty right hand. Oh! Big left. Oh, that one hurt him.
Get him back to half guard.
That bruise on his torso is getting bad. Trying to take the back here. Oh, nice right hand. Big right hand. He's got the back and secures both hooks.
Get him top mount. All right, let's try to work.
Full mount, not good. He hip escapes for the full mount.
Got back to mount. Oh, god damn it. Fuck. Jesus, I cannot believe I messed that up. Got a good position and screwed it up. Parries, 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 man.
2 minutes remain in the round. And they move out of the clinch. Nice double jab by LP.
Let's move out.
Good roundhouse kick to the midsection. Nice leg kick.
Back and forth.
John Dotson is continuing to punish that wounded eye. And you can see that the swelling continues to get worse and worse. He's absolutely targeting that eye. You can clearly see, and he's landing combinations on it repeatedly. Wow, what a huge block. Oh, big knee. Solid jab. He landed a huge uppercut.
Oh, oh, combination.
Beautiful body shot there, too. Powerful jab.
You really just, the striking system becomes 100% unenjoyable when you're dealing with someone that uses parries a lot. It really, and I don't blame them. It's in the game, you might as well use it, but it becomes very, very unenjoyable. I don't enjoy it. I'm going to push really, really hard for them to either nerf it hard to the point. I mean, you can't throw a jab. Like, you can't depend on your jab in this game. You can't constantly lead with the jab, because if you try to do that, you're going to get head kicked, and that is a problem. That's a problem in a game. They're supposed to.
Good job blocking the punch.
That's just a problem.
Great punch by Almeida. 1-2 connects. That bruise on his outer thigh is really getting nasty. Oh, he caught him. Tagged him with the Superman punch. Good defense there. Joe, there we see our total strikes landed. Oh, man. Great head kick. Oh, big right hand clipped him.
Good game, bro. Good game. You won. Good game.
Unbelievable. Tremendous TKO. Great stoppage by the referee.
Good game.
Let's check out the action on our with the official decision.
Let's move on. Flyweight Ortiz. Oh, we got to fight right away. There he is. Dustin Ortiz. Never used this guy. Grinder, ground and pound. So he's supposed to be a grappler. His stamina for the flyweight division is not that good. But we'll see how he does. We'll see what happens.
Coming up next, it's a flyweight showdown between Dustin Ortiz
and Joseph Benavidez.
We're fighting Joseph Benavidez. The good thing is, I mean, that the Muay Thai plum right now, if you face a top ranked player, that's what they're going to use. That's what they're going to use to score points and to do damage very quickly, because you can't block on reaction. Because okay, let me just focus on this fight for now. Who are we fighting? Savage. I don't know who this dude is. All right, let's see what my fighter is good for. Movement is pretty slow. Just slow in general. Why am I doing this? I am getting all these losses, man. Oh my goodness. Why am I doing this? Do I at least have a... I don't have a lead leg head kick. Yeah, this is gonna be a tough one. Caught him with two uppercuts. Caught him another one. Alright, let's just let's try to strike as well as we possibly can. At least this guy's not, you know, abusing the parry. Which makes the striking so much better. I can lead with my jab straight. Caught me with that. Good job. Caught him with that. Keep catching him with that straight. See what happens.
Great job landing a series of punches. Another good shot to the body, Joe. He's really starting to do some significant damage. Absolutely, Mike.
Try to catch him with a straight every time he's recovering.
Swing and a miss by Benavidez. Oh, that's a big straight. And he got clipped again. Good striking. Final minute of round one. Good block, and he delivers the straight count. 1-2. Inside leg kick.
I don't have a head kick at all. Like, none. Caught him.
He's in big, big trouble here. 15 seconds.
Going to the clinch. He got me down. Good round. The striking just becomes so much better. It becomes so much better. You can start coming up with better combinations when the parry is just so minimal. I can't stress that enough. I mean, my combos started coming out better. I was coming up with more effective shots. It absolutely, without a shred of a doubt, needs to be toned down. I don't have a head kick, so I guess I'm just going to have to try to go to the body. Oh, caught me with that one. Caught him.
He's doing a great job of timing these shots. Joe, he's keeping very busy. Look at the numbers. Total strikes land. Nice. Nice 1-2.
Dropped him.
Hard diving punch. Punches and punches.
He recovered.
Powerful left hand.
Try to get the mount real quick. Let's get up. Posture up, buddy.
Hip escape. Gets out of the full mount.
Defended against that one. Let's fake transitions and get him out. Oh, missed that one. Mount. Dude, I can't deny transitions and mount, and he got up. Wow. My ground game is not good.
He missed on that jab. Big left by Ortiz. Joey commented on it earlier, and here we see once again the utilization of the jab. Benavides with a good punch.
That's
nice strikes landing. Good work blocking that. Quick jab.
Great exchanges.
The straight connects. Excellent head movement. Good block, straight count. Nice parry there.
He's doing a really good job of timing his shots and landing a good series of strikes here.
Benavides with a straight that scores.
Caught him again. Just keep trying to catch him.
Oh, just missed with that over. Ortiz with a good left.
Excellent job of timing these combinations.
Solid left hook to the body by Ortiz. Great job blocking that punch. Ortiz with a solid jab.
Okay, I need to slow down.
Defense with the parry.
Took me down. He wanted to get that takedown at the end of the round. I'm loving this fight so far. Pretty good fight. Let's touch it up. Man, I wish I had a head kick. The parry should be more of a defensive mechanic in the game, not something that gives you this huge counter window to where you can do so much damage. It's
trying to connect on that jab. Nice right hand. Joe, that was well done blocking the punch. That
eye is getting losing stamina now.
Solid jab by Ortiz. And he's eating some shots. Ortiz gets caught by the inside leg kick.
He's really doing a good job of controlling distance and getting off these shots.
Found a home for that. That's a good kick.
All right, let's. I'm gonna try to play a little passive now because I'm losing stamina. I need to score a little. I need to score points.
Nice roundhouse kick to the body.
He clipped him with that one.
And there's another roundhouse kick. Look at this.
Let's see if I can get him to stop blocking his head too much.
Perfect timing with the strikes. Good roundhouse kick to the midsection. Caught him with a left.
And again, amazing. Amazing.
Ortiz with another kick to the body. Joseph Benavides is aware that he is behind on the judges' scorecards, so he's going to look for the finish any way he can.
He's got to either get a submission or get the knockout because he's not going to get a decision.
He just missed with the straight right. Good roundhouse.
Very nice shots landing.
That's a solid straight.
Okay.
Looking for a body shot.
Wow. That was a big left hand he connected with. What a crazy fight this has been, and it's not letting up now. The last minute of this fight, and these guys are
doesn't want to get in that pocket anymore.
Trying to finish this fight.
Ooh, thought I blocked that.
Body kick, look at that. That's a big right hand. Again with a solid kick to the body. Turning into an all-out slugfest.
Got me down. What is this? Round number three? Let's do round number three. Oh, wait. The fight's over. Oh, boy. Who won this fight? I won. Good fight, buddy. I must say, I don't have fun when I'm using characters that I usually don't use. Like the shorter guys, guys with not a lot of reach. I don't have as much fun. But it's just more challenging and more satisfying when I win with characters that I'm not that good with. Okay, next fighter is Panay. I believe that's how you say her name. I hope I got that right. And in my last video, people were challenging me to say the strawweight champion's name. And I believe her name is Joanna Jędrzejczyk. Tell me if I got that right or if I got that wrong. Or Joanna Jędrzejczyk. In Mike Goldberg's terms. Here we go. Strawweight champion. Where is Jessica Panay? No. Right there. There she is. Light glue, guard specialist, risk reward. She's supposed to be a submission fighter. And I do apologize for all the feedback that you get from the controller, the buttons, moving around in my chair. I bet the mic picks all that up. Hope it doesn't annoy you guys too much. I'm sorry if it does. Really am. And I hope you are enjoying these videos. I don't mean to sound too negative sometimes. It's just I do like giving my honest reactions when I play the game. If I rage, then I rage. If I'm frustrated, I'm frustrated. If I'm happy, I'm happy. You know, I don't want to put up some kind of, you know, front, I guess. Just, it is what it is. That's why I love doing these live commentaries. You know, you get to hear me, how I sound when I play the game. Okay, so let's see what Jessica Panay can do against the champion. Ooh, I love fighting this guy. I absolutely adore fighting this dude. His style just makes me... I don't even care if I lose this fight. His style makes me happy. I love his style. I don't have a lead head kick. Caught her with that. This will be a good fight. Oh, caught me.
Joe, that was well done blocking the punch. That connected. That's a good kick. Solid leg kick.
Ooh.
Trying to go to the
caught me with caught her with that.
Good work blocking that. Nice jab.
Ooh, she parried and got a head kick. Excuse me.
Solid jab.
Ooh, caught me with that one.
Oh, very nice. Oh, combination. Oh, and another jab.
It's a good fight so far.
Hard straight punch.
Ooh, got caught. I need to work her stamina a little bit.
Joe, she's really on point with her strikes tonight. Good connection with the strike by Penny. Nice kicks. Young Jake caught again. That huge head kick was blocked.
It's a pretty good fight.
Under 90 seconds now. Solid overhand left.
It's just so so refreshing to fight someone like this. I can't even begin to describe how so refreshing it is. I mean, we're playing the distance game. We're using our footwork. We're using the jab. We're using the straights. He's feinting. It's just so nice. Feels so nice. Oh, I can't even begin. Oh, caught me. Hurt her. She's hurt. And this is when my striking shines, man. When I face an opponent like this. Good round, buddy. Good round.
Let's take a look at some of the action here. And here's some real clean striking.
When I face someone like this who kind of just makes the game look just makes it look so much better than it probably actually is. Let's touch it up. Let's get back to work.
Nice, nice kick. That cut on her nose is really bleeding. Oh, good
caught her. Oh boy, got caught.
Good jab by Penny.
Trying to work on her conditioning a little bit with those shots. Okay, coming over the top with the Superman punch.
Solid shot to the body. Shots.
Caught me with that.
Oh, solid jab. Oh, another body kick. Wow, another big jab scores.
Ooh, really ooh, getting caught.
Missed with that one. That's a solid straight. Late kick. Well, inside late kick. Good left hand by Young Jake Chen. Nice leg kick. Very nice. Found a home for that.
They are exchanging here, Mike.
The story of this second round, her ability to land the uppercut. Good job of timing strikes here. Nice roundhouse kick to the body. Good kicks. Great utilization of the jab. And there's another roundhouse kick. Solid jab by Penny. 1-2.
Might come over the top with that uppercut. I got caught with that one.
Wow, what a powerful leg kick that was. Good counter. Excellent job of timing these combinations. Penny with the kick to the midsection. Great counter with the left hook. Looking for the big finishing punch. Nice shot. Another one.
Caught her.
Nice combination.
Woo! My head's getting hurt. I need to watch out.
Oh, that's a great block to the punch.
Watch out.
Joe, she's looking to land another uppercut. Very much like she did earlier.
I don't want to get into a defensive shell, though. I love how, like, she just leads with that jab. Oh, no. I'm hurt. Oh, no. Don't do it. Back off. No, don't do it. Oh, God damn it. Let's get out of here. Good round. Good round. She definitely won that one. Well, he definitely won that one. It's a dude playing. It is so hard keeping up with the champion on the feet. But I'm going to keep this fight standing just because I'm enjoying the striking so much. I'm enjoying it.
Straight by Penny. Kick to the body. Big combination. Body kick. Look at that.
Another big shot lands.
There's a left that connects.
Getting caught with the uppercuts. I wish I had.
Oh, big body kick.
Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed.
Shoot.
Again. Amazing. Amazing.
Good 1-2 combo by Young Jae Chang. She continues to connect with her punches. That jab extremely effective throughout this entire fight. There it is, swing and a miss.
Nice jab. Big shot to the liver.
Oh no, I beat her. This fight's over. Good fight, buddy. Good fight. So much respect to you. Good fight. I love that dude so much. Literally my favorite EA Sports UFC 2 player. I got him with the body kick. He was a top player in EA Sports UFC 1 as well. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. That's it for this episode of Featured Fighters. Once again, we were successful with every single fighter except one, and that was John Dodson. It's okay. It's all right. I'm loving this series. I'm going to keep it going every single day. I'm going to run through the featured fighters and try to get a win with them. And as long as you guys keep enjoying the series, I'm going to keep the series alive. But thanks for all your support. I really appreciate it. And I will see you guys in the next video. Be safe.